Hi guys, I am here for another weekly plan with me to plan for the week of April 23rd through the 29th in my Erin Condren Vertical Weekly Planner. It is my 2018 planner. I'm super excited. The next year's planners are about to be revealed from Erin Condren and excited to pick one up. So I am using my Farmer's Market Weekly Kit. This was supposed to be one of my kits for the month of May, which starts next week, but I didn't have any kit to use this week, and I really, really wanted to use one that had sunflowers in it because this is the week that I finally started taking my sunflowers outside. None of them have like sprouted or whatever sunflowers themselves, but they are getting to the point where they're almost ready to transplant into one of my huge planters. Anyway, so this was one of my May releases from the shop. I know the vertical kit is still available. I don't know about the mini kit, but let me walk you through my format. So first we have the 8 full boxes, and yeah, I planned for the double box and our 5 flags. Our ombre checklist, these colors are so fun. Half boxes page, our little things in solid washi, our functional page. I don't know what color of weekend banner I'm using yet. This is my first time where I've had an option of what color I want to use with my kits. We have our date covers and our deco, our glitter, and then the bottom washi, which, of course, sunflowers. So before I move on, I am actually filming this on Tuesday. My life has gone kind of hectic. In fact, I'm pretty sure I haven't uploaded the last 2 weeks of spreads, so I wanted to show you guys them. So this one, you can see I didn't even like finish filling this out, but it was my spring showers kit. And then last week, I did this on Instagram Live, I just did on my stories, but I used this kit from Station Stickers that is foiled, but I'm having a hard time showing it off, and I like how this week turned off. I even used the foiled date covers from her shop. Anyway, I'm filming this late, but I'm hoping to still get it up this week. I have been attempting to catch up on everything in my life and, you know, get back to a good rhythm. But I feel like it's going to be a bit before I get to that, just because I've been working insane hours. Like Monday night, you know, I got in at around, like, I think I got to the office around 9, but I had to go stop and pick up some stuff that my boss needed. So like 8:30 is when I started working for the day, and I didn't leave the office until 10 p.m. because there was a big project I was working on, which is just crazy to me to leave at that time. I'm not going to use the sunflower flags, just because I feel like there's already a lot of sunflowers in this spread, and it doesn't need any more. So, like, you know, I got off work at 10 o'clock. I prepped a few orders last night, but mostly I got $2 Tuesday prepped, which I'm doing $2 Tuesday now. You've probably seen me already, like, do those releases on this channel. But it's $2 Tuesday right now, and I got all those ready, and they did go live right at midnight. Last week they did not. I accidentally fell asleep, because I am the worst. Ooh, I accidentally grabbed an 11. So that's kind of what I've been up to. Today I left work only around, like, 6 o'clock, which wasn't bad, because since I stayed at work so late, I told my boss I was sleeping in, so I didn't come in till 10. And then, you know, leaving at 6, so I got my full 8 hours, although not hourly. But it was pretty stressful. It was just kind of one of those days where I'm jumping from meeting to meeting to meeting, or, like, from thing to thing. And there was a lot of stuff I just wanted to do for myself, because, like, I have a ton of side projects. But I never got around to them. And then I need to still do a lot tonight. The big thing is my boyfriend, he lives with his dad right now, and he did a lot of projects for him this week, and several of them were, like, doing some painting. He rebuilt his mailbox for him because it broke and all of this, and he realized that with a new mailbox and, like, the way he painted the side of the house, that they would need new numbers for it. And he decided that instead of going out and buying them, because he looked at what was available, like, you know, generic house numbers, he didn't like them, so he asked if I would make him some custom ones, since I have a cutting machine. And I agreed to it, because I'm a lovely person. So I'm working on that. So I am going to use the girl. I'm a little bummed. So far it's been super rainy all freaking week, which is rough because I was like really finally looking forward to some nicer weather. So let's grab the glitter headers. I am again just going to go in the order of the kit. These colors are really vibrant, so I'm super hoping the weather kind of gets warmer this week, or else this is going to be kind of a ridiculous kit to be using in such a dreary week. Although this is the first week since like November, maybe earlier, that I have not worn a coat at all. Like, I always have a jacket just because I wear very generic outfits to work, like black pants, blouse, and a dark jacket, sometimes gray, usually black. I don't like getting too dressed up unless I need to, but this is the first time that I haven't, like, I've worn like the jacket, but I haven't had to wear a coat. So I do have my eraser with me. This is actually, I dug it out of my pile of stuff. I have this from college. So first we have a checklist. I write these out just because otherwise this is very annoying to figure out as I'm doing it on camera. And then I'm going to go ahead and just, so it's full box checklist. I'm doing this one just so I can figure out where the last glitter header needs to go a better way. So honestly, I don't need a checklist for Monday just because Monday has passed already, but I can just go ahead and cover it up if I feel like I don't need it, or I can stick stuff on that to remind myself what I did. Okay. Oopsies. I hope this part isn't too boring. Let me know if it is. Other exciting things happening. This week is, again, pretty hectic. I don't know if to push it back, and hopefully I can get this video up soon enough that I can actually get your thoughts on this. So I would prefer, personally, if my like new releases, because I do like monthly releases, most of the time would come out on like the first of the month, and then I would have a weekend sale or something. But this month, the first lands on a Tuesday, so I can't exactly have a weekend sale. So I was planning on doing new releases this week, but I don't know. I kind of feel like I want to do them on the first. Otherwise, like, I don't know. I feel like they're not really. I don't know how to describe what I'm trying to say, but like they're not really like monthly releases. And beyond that, this weekend, well, Friday at least, there is Scribble Prince Co., if you didn't know, is releasing her four-year bundle. So I don't think I'm going to do, I don't know. Tell me what you guys think. Do you guys have a preference? Like, the reason I usually do them on weekends is because, you know, everybody's payday is on Friday. So, you know, that's when most shops do new releases. So, like, you don't have to, like, because if I do my sale on a different day and you guys don't have your paycheck or something, like, you won't be able to get the sale. Oh, God, that looks so good. I kind of wish I hadn't gone with, like, this, but with the, like, diagonal, but it had to be done just with how I was planning on the other side. So let me flip this over and get to it. So I'm going to put in my planner that I'm planning on getting new releases out on Saturday, just because there was no way that I would be able to do new releases at like Friday at noon or whatever while I tried to get the Scribble Prince Co. bundle. It wasn't going to happen because I'm getting that bundle one way or another. If I have to beat someone down, I will get it. What did I mess up on? Oh, I didn't. So I was thinking I would do Saturday and then have the sale run for 72 hours, whenever that might end. So, yeah. And then I also need to have to catch up on videos. So I have several Rewind Plan With Me's that I'm behind on, you haven't seen those in a while. Like, it's gotten so bad with my videos that the last two videos I uploaded were $2 Tuesday videos, meaning that I uploaded $2 Tuesday video 1 week, and then the next week, the only, like, 7 days later was when I uploaded my next video, just because I'm putting a lot more priority on different things in my life. Number one, like, outside of my real job, my number one, well, and I guess my boyfriend, I don't know. I'm putting more priority on my shop than I am on releasing YouTube videos, which is sad, because my whole planner world started with me being super into making planner videos. Okay. So, let's put in, so this is the double box. So let's put in a checklist, a header, and then the double box. This part takes forever. Let me know if you're okay with me just fast forwarding through this, just because it's not very interesting. Anything special happening this week? Tomorrow, which is Wednesday for me. Oh, that is not good. It is one of my coworkers' birthdays. He isn't, like, in the same department as me anymore, but would have been 2 years ago. He was my boss, and he was a really good boss, like, beyond handling my, like, being a good boss. He also was very good at handling, like, the emotional part of being a supervisor, meaning, like, if I ever had things happening in my life or things were getting to me, because the job can be stressful. He did an amazing job of being a part of the support system for both me and, like, everyone else on the team. So, I went and I got him, like, balloons and a card, and I kind of feel guilty because my current boss's birthday was, like, a week or so ago, and I thought her, like, deputy basically would get her a, like, all that stuff, and I didn't talk to her, and she didn't, which, shitty on her part, but whatever. But I kind of hope she doesn't, I hope she doesn't get offended that I didn't do any of this for her. Okay. Glad that's over, because I am done chatting. So, I have my pre-planning sheet. Let's jump in with Monday, with little things. Again, Monday has already passed, so I know everything that happened. First, we are going to put down a meal little thing. For dinner, I had Noodles and Company, just because that was the only place near my office that was still open. On Mondays, Monday was Etsy payday, and then on this day, I'm going to put it down as a heart, was our weekly staff meeting. I don't know why I keep marking this. It's every week. How do I want to do this? So, I guess we could do top to bottom. Sure. So, let's start with a small icon to mark that. I'm going to use an asterisk to mark that it was an early morning. I had to, again, be somewhere at 8:30 to grab some stuff. Then for lunch, I took my lunch outside of work, and let's first mark down what I had for lunch. This one I'm only marking down because it's, I mean, special, I guess, is not the right word, but this doesn't happen often. It shouldn't happen often. I had McDonald's for lunch, so I needed to rush home to grab something, and I didn't have time, and I didn't meal prep this last Sunday because I'm the worst. Actually, I'm going to flip this over. So I grabbed McDonald's on the way to my meeting and just, like, ate in my car. So to mark that, I actually drew some, like, McDonald's-inspired doodles with, like, Happy Meals and all of this, and they're on my iPad, and I'm hoping I can get them released as doodles for my next, new releases, but my iPad's dead, and I haven't, like, put it in sticker form yet, so I grabbed this fast food sheet from Coffee Monsters Co., and I did not realize that there were fast food doodles on this that had fries, so I'm gonna use that to mark that. But the thing that I had to go pick up was some Amazon orders, so, like, very weird. Very, very weird. So for the last few weeks, I have been getting notifications saying, your package has been delivered, and then from Amazon. And then when I get home, there's no package from Amazon. And I was getting super pissed So it turns out that instead of delivering them to my front door, they were delivering them to the main office for my apartment complex. Unfortunately, my main office doesn't accept packages, and when I called them every time I got that, they're like, we don't have any packages from you. So what I assume is like they left it at the front door of the main office because they're not open all the time, just when they're showing somebody, and somebody just like grabbed and stole it. So I was like, those are lost. Amazon refunded me, and they reshipped everything after I repurchased them. Anyway, so I got a call from my office, or the main office here last week, saying that they had found all of the items, which basically tells me that every single time I called, they weren't actually looking for them, which hurts my feelings. And also kind of makes me upset because I had to like reorder everything. So they let me know, hey, all of your packages are here. When are you gonna come get them? So after being like, I have been talking to you guys about this for the last few weeks, what the heck? They apologized and said, yeah, we just didn't communicate between us that this stuff was here. So I went and picked up several weeks worth of various packages, and I have a moral dilemma. Do I call Amazon, and this is a package sticker if you can't see because it's so bright. I have a moral dilemma. Do I call Amazon and let them know that all of these are here and return them, or do I just keep them? Because I feel like it's wrong to just keep them, but on the other hand, are they really going to notice that I didn't send back my $2 whatever? Let me know. I am leaning towards either returning them or like donating them because I think I would feel way too guilty to keep them. So anyway, that is what I am marking here. Very long story. Sorry about that. Next, I'm going to grab, I want to grab a little thing, but I don't know if I have a little thing to mark this. So I could use this little thing. Let's see if I have an icon. I'm trying to not use as many character stickers and stuff, just because I feel like I overuse them. So I want to use this. Do I have a computer? Yeah. Again, it's yellow, so I'm going to use this little thing, and then I'm going to cover up the TV with a yellow computer icon. Again, these lights are bright. This is the day I stayed at work until 10 p.m. I had a huge project I needed to get done before midnight. I mean, I guess I could have pushed it to the next day, but I had so much other stuff that it would not have worked out well. So that was that, and then I left this blank, so my office is hiring somebody else for my department. Actually, when they first told me they were hiring someone for my department, I freaked out, with good reason, in my opinion. So, I don't know if I've told this story yet, but I'm going to tell it again. So, sucks to be you guys if you've already heard it. So let's pretend my job title is Director of Analytics. That's not my real job title. It doesn't really have anything to do with my job. I just made it up. What would you do, like, or your job is that? So what would you do if one morning they sent you a message saying, hey, the department closely related to you is hiring a Director of Analytics. Do you have anyone in mind? Now, keep in mind that I do all the analytics for that department. So I freaked out. I'm like, am I not doing a good job? Am I training my replacement? Why are you hiring someone with my exact same job title to do some of the exact same things I was hired to do? I absolutely freaked out. I had to call my boyfriend to come to work because I was trying not to cry. And I'm like, do they hate me? Do they hate me? I freaked out. So this happened a few weeks ago. I actually cried at work. I had a talk with my boss. I unfortunately cried in front of her. She sent me flowers because she felt so bad. But apparently they forgot to talk to me about it and they just assumed. Basically, they decided that, I'm still not a huge fan of and I wish they would have talked to me beforehand. They decided that since my portfolio of what I was working on kept growing because I kept finding little side projects to add to it, they wanted to hire basically an assistant for me that would help this particular department whose needs were about to grow. This person wouldn't report to me, but they would work like in the same office as me, which sucks. I have to share an office, but it's a pretty big office. So, they wouldn't report to me, but, you know, they'd have to clear any projects with me, and they would, you know, like, basically they would build the stuff for this other department, but they would be under my department. Not really sure how that'll work, and that was settled. I'm still not a huge fan of the whole thing. And if it was up to me, I'm not sure if I would bring this person on, but I decided to make the best of it. After a meeting where they were like, are you okay with this? And it was very obvious they weren't asking. They were just telling me this is happening. We're sorry we didn't bring you on earlier. I decided the best way to make the best of this was to find someone for the role that I knew would be subordinate to me, which sounds awful, but it's someone that I know that I can trust to do the job well enough to let them do it, but I would know at the end of the day isn't going to try to assert my power. So we've interviewed a few people, but on this day is when my favorite candidate got interviewed. I'm pushing hard for him. I'm in on the interviews, and I'm trying not to be too biased against the other people, but I really need someone in this role that I can trust. That is my Monday. I just talked, I'm at 20 minutes and we're all the way through Monday. Other things happened that aren't worth mentioning. I dropped stuff at the post office. I actually yelled at my post office. Nobody's really mentioned anything to me, but I've been having these issues where I drop off something, like let's say I'll drop something off Monday, they won't scan it and you won't get an update on it until like Wednesday or Thursday when it arrives at like the main processing facility for my state. And, like, I stand there and I'm like, can you scan this? And this time she stood in front of me and she scanned the form and then she passed it along. And I'm standing there checking the app saying maybe it's just not updating. And it turns out, like, even when she scans it, she's not actually scanning it. She was just going through the motions. And apparently, like, my local post office doesn't have a scanning system that works or hasn't for a while. I don't know. I made a lot of complaints about it and hopefully it gets fixed. But anyway, Monday, that was a part of my life. Sorry if you guys have been getting like a shipping notification and it's not updating for several days. I'm doing my best, but I can't go to a different post office because the next one is like an extra 30 minutes away. Let's move past Monday, get that out of the way. Tuesday. Let's start with my little things. Again, meal little thing, what did I have? Oh, for dinner, I was bad again, and I picked up more McDonald's just because I was out running errands, and it was easy. Ugh, I feel awful. So let's start off with the fact that Tuesday was $2 Tuesday, my second $2 Tuesday. So I brought out two stickers to mark this. So originally I brought these out. These are from, the freebies that went out with last week's $2 Tuesday. But I also had the option of using these, which are the freebies that went out with this week's $2 Tuesday. But just because they're so much bigger, I'm going to use this. So this is just the length of a box, and you can just stick it in. I actually really like these, like a ton. So $2 Tuesday, yay! Also on this day was our bi-weekly, every 2 week staff planning meeting. We just sit around and plan stuff. Actually, I'm going to save this one. So first, I was having such a, not like a bad day, I was just like drowsy, like no other, that I had to go pick up Starbucks. I try not to drink a lot of Starbucks. There's a Starbucks in my building, not my apartment building, but my office building, which is bad. But I picked up some much needed Starbucks on this day, today. So I'm going to use this guy here because I had a hot latte, but I'm going to use the small version of him. These are from the Coffee Monsters Co. And then I'm going to put in a appointment label to mark the staff planning meeting. I actually really love these. Every 2 weeks we'd sit and talk about all our projects, get updates, do presentations, things like that. So again, those stickers were from the Coffee Monsters Co. I'm actually going to need those again, I think. What else? The only other thing I want to mark for today is that, what was it? Oh, I had to make a run to Walmart today first to grab some vinyl for the project my boyfriend wants me to make numbers for his house or his dad's house, and then also to get things for my coworker's birthday. So to mark that, I'll just use the shopping cart. I know it's the wrong color, but we'll all be okay with it. And I have a lot of things to add to my to-do list that I still need to get done tonight. Let's move on to Wednesday. Little things first. So, meal first. Wednesday's actually gonna be an insane day that I'm honestly not looking forward to. So, oh, I forgot to grab a sticker. Okay, I had to grab my HelloFresh stickers because I'll need them in a second. Actually, you know what? I'm not gonna use this. I have a HelloFresh box coming in, but instead of using the doodles because they take up a lot of space, I'm just going to use a box just because I never use these. Okay, never mind. Come on. Okay. Hello. Oh, I did mark it in my planner. Why didn't I bring out a sticker for it? Oh, I did. I definitely did. Oops. So on this day, at work, we have a monthly fundraising lunch where we invite all our big donors and they have like a special speaker and all that fun stuff. And they let us worker bees come to it to both, you know, interact with everyone and for people, you know, to get to know us, but also because the food is bomb. So that is tomorrow, Wednesday. Sorry, it's Tuesday right now, so I'm just gonna keep saying tomorrow. So to mark that, I have from Scribble Prints Co. This is Celeste, their character, just like all dressed up. I am running out of these because I use these. These are the only stickers I have to mark, like getting dressed up, and I really need to find another place for those because I just need to get dressed up. Also on this day is my coworker's birthday, the one that I had to pick up the things for. I mean, I guess I didn't have to, but I wanted to. So to mark that, I'm going to grab some more washi. Not that much washi. And I'm putting in an appointment label. So to mark his birthday, I have these birthday stickers from the Scribble Prints Co., right? Yes, it's just the character Celeste. This is a sampler I got. Just her holding balloons, which I think is cute. And I wanted this section to like kind of match. So, HelloFresh meals, that. One more thing to put in, and I'm going to put it down below. There is a big important conference call of our board of directors. Usually we have these meetings in person, and I just have to like show up and give cute updates. But this time it's a conference call because we couldn't all be there, or I guess they couldn't all be there, and I have to administer the back end because they have to do like voting and stuff, and when I'm not like their IT or tech person, but my job is so closely related to technology that they just assume, oh, Abby knows how to do it, which I do, but that's not the point. So I have to administer the call, which I am not looking forward to. So I'm going to use this guy on the computer. These are customer service stickers from the Coffee Monsters Co. that I absolutely adore. Hopefully I don't mess it up. So that is my Wednesday. So cute. First half of the week all put together. I am going to put down for Thursday a meal little thing, and then I get to do my favorite thing ever. That's it. That's all I have planned for Thursday so far. Isn't that beautiful? Nothing. Hopefully on this day is when I get a lot of not just getting orders out, but I prep a lot of my new releases. But that is all I am doing on Thursday. So excited for me. Friday just jumps right back to being busy. So, let's start by putting in an appointment label on, So this is again for HelloFresh. I just feel like I do the same things every week with HelloFresh, so I shouldn't have to continually, you know, use big things, but I need to choose my meals on this day. They're due by Saturday, but I like choosing them on Friday, and I might switch up the day they get delivered because they usually get delivered on Wednesday, but I'm kind of feeling maybe doing it Monday. I'm not sure. On Fridays, there is a, so like I have my weekly staff meeting, we have our bi-weekly staff like planning meeting, and now a new meeting we have at work is every Friday. Is it's kind of like an interdepartmental meeting, and it's not something we ever really do, and it's just all of the departments get together to update and coordinate. It's a very short meeting. We just had our first one this last week, and it's basically so, because a lot of our departments overlap in like goals and stuff, but they need to be different departments, just because, you know, where the money's coming from and like things like that. But sometimes our efforts overlap, and these meetings are a way to cut down on us like doubling and doing the exact same projects and doing the exact same things, or even if we are doing that, to coordinate a little better. So those are Friday mornings. I mean, they're fine. I just sit and I take notes. Sometimes they ask me for things, but since my, like, other than this new person that we'll be hiring, I cover all of those departments for things, so it's just a really great way for me to get questions out of the way without running between offices looking for people. This is a big day, by the way, so sit tight. Next, this is payday. I am going to take my payday girls. I'm going to grab a small one. No, let's do a large one. I'm just going to put it up here, just because I'm not going to have room for her down below. On this day, I have two very large bills due. I actually have to pay off some other bills before this, so hopefully my paycheck lasts, which is only half of a joke. Not sure where the camera cut me off, but yeah, my phone overheated. Things stopped. So anyway, I was talking about bills. I've got two huge bills to pay on this day. Luckily, it is payday. I do have some bills to pay beforehand, but to mark that, I have from Happy Deo or Daya stickers. I don't know how to pronounce this, so I'm sorry. It's her character looking all nervous while looking at bills, which these are some pretty big ones. These are, other than rent, they're my two biggest ones. Unhappy about them at all times. Sorry, my pre-planning. Making sure I got everything. Okay, big things happening on this day. Real big things. So, the Scribble Prints Co. 2-year bundle comes out on this. No, not 2-year. What am I saying? 4-year bundle all day. 4-year bundle comes out on this day. Yeah, maybe I'll be able to get my words out. This is going to be hard to get. So, unfortunately, and like, she can do whatever she wants. It's her shop, but she decided to include some washi from one of her favorite shops, which is Simply Gilded. If you don't know, Simply Gilded washi is like gold right now in the planner community for some reason. Like I saw a single roll of washi like that they originally bought for like $10 or whatever, because she has pretty reasonable prices, sell for $200 on a buy-sell trade group. Like, how crazy can you get? So I don't get the hype around Simply Gilded washi. I think it's cute. I think it's fun. And if I were to make it in time for a sale, I would buy it from her shop. But I am never going to spend $200 on a roll of washi. I probably would never even spend $25. Watch me say this and then like get deep into the Simply Gilded obsession. Anyway, so one of the things that Andrea from Scribble Prints Co. decided to include in her bundle is a roll of exclusive Simply Gilded washi. So the big concern now is that all those crazy Simply Gilded fangirls are going to rush Scribble Prints Co. and try to get one of those packs just so they can get the washi. She's doing two releases, so hopefully I can get them, but it'll be on Friday. So I have from Coffee Monsters Co. These are Happy Mail emojis, but these ones are like serious and angry, and they say buy stickers. Her bundle is $100, not $100, it's $50 plus $3 shipping, so here's to hoping that I can pick one up. The last thing I have to mark for this day, my best friend is coming to town, which is so exciting. She is just passing through, but she would like to get lunch with me. So I didn't bring out a sticker to mark this because I don't have any, like, friend stickers, which is weird, but I am going to use a heart from the icons page. Very excited to see her. Hopefully her coming and the buy stickers does not overlap, because I don't know how to explain to her what I need to do. But I believe that's my Friday. Let me make sure. Yeah, that's my Friday. Let's move on to Saturday. Let's start with a little thing. My plans for Saturday have changed since yesterday, actually. So I'm glad kind of I waited to film this, because otherwise it would have looked weird. So the first thing I want to put in is, let me find it, a movie marquee. I don't have any of them that are the correct color, so I'm just going to use a green one with, will this work? I think so. With a green glitter header behind it as washi. And some more stuff below it. This is the day that I would like new releases to go live. That's the goal. Again, like, my life is kind of always in flux, so that's the goal, but it's not necessarily when it will come out. But I'll keep you guys up to date. And if you ever have any questions about those, you can feel free to message me on Instagram, or I don't really answer on YouTube that fast, maybe on Etsy. So that is hopefully when June releases will go out. I am hoping to do more smaller releases, so like all the kits and stuff I have planned for this would be enough for like two normal releases, just because there's just so much good stuff I want to put out there. So I'm considering like doing more releases, just because I think it'd be easier on people if I had like, you know, maximum four kits I release at a time. So next I am putting in a, let's put in an appointment label. This is the thing I forgot about. I agreed to go to a fundraising dinner with my boss on this day. I think it'll be fun, but again, like, I forgot I agreed to do this. I thought I had a sticker to mark this. I do not. But, oopsies. So I originally was going to go back to my house and do more cleaning like I did last weekend. I guess I didn't film that. I went to my house last week and I did a ton of cleaning, but I can't on Saturday because I agreed to go to this dinner. It'll be fun, I hope. I can't bring my boyfriend because there were only a limited number of tickets, but I do get to go with my coworkers. And I get to dress up, so I might buy a new dress for this occasion. So that is my Saturday. I'm hoping to get, so since my Saturday's so bare, I can probably like get these new releases up later in the day, and that'll give me the morning to like relax, because it's not just making the new releases, which does take a lot of time, it's getting all the listing pictures and the listings ready to go, which for me is the thing that takes the absolute longest amount of time, just because I don't know, I get bored when I'm not making stickers. Anyway, let's do Sunday. So first of all, I have a bill due on Sunday. I have a feeling this bill is not actually due on Sunday, but rather due on, like, Friday. But I have it listed for Sunday, so why not? Then on this day, we're putting in a three-dot checklist. Let me see what headers I have. Oh no, I dropped a sticker sheet. Headers, headers, headers. Wherefore out though? There we go. In green, let's do a to-do header. We're gonna need some washi. So this is the day that I am going to travel out to my house. I feel like I mention this every video, and I feel like I've already mentioned it here, but I live in an apartment, but the house I lived in before I lived here, my parents own, and I'm currently in the process of cleaning, fixing it up, doing all kinds of things to get it ready to rent out. Last weekend, I did a lot of, like, trash-style cleaning, doing a lot of yard work, cleaning out the garage. This day is a lot of, like, junk cleaning and sticking stuff in my car and taking them to Goodwill. So to mark that, I have from the Coffee Monsters Co. These are spring cleaning emojis. I'm going to use the smaller one. So this is just going to be my to-do list for this day. I just realized I'm going to have to do a lot of my normal Sunday to-dos on Saturday. So, like, getting groceries and, oh God, who knows what else. So next, let me grab the weekend banner. What color do I need to pull in more, green or blue? Definitely blue. So let me stick that down here. I never have room for this in the kit. I guess I could cover up the full boxes, but who wants to do that? Let's move on to the sidebar. No, sorry, you didn't get a great look at this. This looks so blank. I'll eventually fill it out. I still do no white space over there. I just fill it out later. So let me grab my habit trackers and my washi page. So let's put you down first. I have, I think, two habits for this week, right? So the first habit, which is going to be the one for this, and I don't have a sticker for this because I couldn't figure out what kind of sticker I needed to use to mark it, is that I want to check the weather every day. Very, very weird one. I have put my plants outside on my porch, and hopefully I can do a video about it for you guys eventually, but I need to check the weather, like Monday and Tuesday, since it was so rainy, I needed to just pull them back from the edge or they would get so much water they would drown. If it's going to get cold at night, I'm gonna bring them inside. They're still my babies, gotta take good care of them or else they're gonna die on me. My second habit is all about my hair. Just, I usually, like, have one great hair day, which is usually Monday, and then the rest of the week I'm like, screw it, Like already Monday I had a great hair day. Tuesday I just was like, I'm putting this up in a bun or a ponytail, I don't care. And I recently, this is gonna sound really awful, so we have like anonymous reviews you can do of people, like, and usually they're used just to send like good vibes to people, like had a great, you know, project with this person. Somebody sent me an anonymous message saying, I can tell when you're having like bad hair days and it's so unprofessional. I did report that to my manager and I'm like, yeah, this is absolute BS. Screw this guy. Or girl, I guess. And she's like, don't worry about it. Like, you've never looked unprofessional. But I get what they were saying. And I know I shouldn't take this to heart. Like, my boss was like, do not listen to this. You don't need to improve on this. It's not affecting you in any way. But unfortunately, I kind of agree with the anonymous jerk who put in that suggestion. I really, really do not put a huge amount of effort into my looks, and I'm okay with it. I have very generic outfits that I am comfortable in. I wear the same pair of flats every day. I don't put on makeup because it makes my skin break out because I forget to take it off. But my hair is one thing that has always bothered me. So I am going to work on that. Yeah. Anyway, so I extended my checklist, and this is where you can really tell that the dots for my small checklist and my large checklist are so different. And I was considering changing that so they matched. But I don't know if you guys prefer large check, like, circles or small ones, so let me know. But I just know I need a very long to-do list this week. So that was my long way of saying my habit for this week is, you know, like, did I put enough effort into making my hair look nice? And, like, now that I say it, I sound like a crazy person who really should have listened to my boss and not paid any attention to that jerk. But, unfortunately, I guess they got to me. So, the last thing I'm marking is, let's put it as a, no. Do I have any half boxes I want to use? I want to mark my work hours. I have started reusing my my work planner again, and I wanted to keep track of how many hours I worked this week just so I have a record of it, and I want to put it down here. I'm just going to use some washi right here to cover that up. Great. So to mark that, I have from my shop, these are the Burnett. Abby is her name. Let me see. This is the modern sheet of them. I guess I can use a large one. These are actually not currently in the shop. I took this and a ton of other listings down that I didn't have in all four girl types, and I'm working on getting those up again. So before I move on to deco, I do have an event countdown. I am counting down to the primary elections in my state because I'm just really into elections and voting, and yeah, so 15 days. I'm going to try to like put these different from each other, like on the full boxes, just because I usually, like, they're not covering up anything on the full boxes while still being very, very cute. Okay. Those are placed down. Let's grab some deco. Let's open this back up. So I'm putting the deco up top like I always do. So let's put the bicycle over here. I'm trying to make sure, like, the pieces, like, this sticker is, I don't know if you get what I'm saying. I'm just gonna stop talking. One sunflower on each side. I love sunflowers, guys. Like, so much. Like, a ridiculous amount. Okay, so I am going to cut off all the excess and fill this all in. I did grab my pen. I am back to using a Pilot G207 in black just because all my Paper Mate Inkjoy pens were out and I started using this again. I fell in love with it again. So I'm going to fill this all out or as much as I can and then come back to say goodbye. Okie dokie, filled it all in as much as I could. Let me show you what is all left in the kit. So the front page, I just have some flags left. Ooh, this page only has two checklists. Actually used a lot on this page. used more than I usually do on this, but still a ton left. A lot left on this page. I gotta figure out what I'm planning next week. Some headers left and an appointment label I placed, and I used up most of my washi. Anyway, thank you guys so much for joining me for this video. I'm so sorry that I suck at putting out videos. I am trying to get all caught up and then I can get back to like a regular schedule. But other than that, I'm so excited to finally put this down. And the sticker kit, I'm so glad I put this together. I mean, that sounds really conceited, but I truly love this. And I checked while I was gone and this kit is still available in the shop. If you're interested. Other than that, thank you guys so much for joining me. I think I already said that. I'll link all the shops down below. I've been getting much better at that. And I will see you in my next video. Bye!